Alright, hey guys, this is Stranger Things coming to you with a very different style of vlogging from the one I usually do. For once, it's not a vlog where I'm doing a run, but in this case, I'm just doing a vlog with my computer screen, even though admittedly I just came home from a run, which is why I'm doing my vlog at this time, 12:27 a.m. And that's why I've got to be a bit quiet about it. But I want to very quickly do this vlog on this website called Dataquest, as you can see on my screen here. I will try to make this a short vlog, but essentially what Dataquest is really just a learning website where you can learn about data science, as you can see on the screen. So I know there are many sites that you can learn data science from, but this is the one I've chosen to go with, mainly because I was given an opportunity to try out the platform for free. So let me just share my experience on Dataquest. So when you create the Dataquest account, basically you'll be able to choose a path in terms of data science. So these are the different paths that you can go along with. Let's say I choose to want to go on the data engineering path. They will specially curate a step-by-step courseware based on the path that I've chosen. So you can see if I choose a based on the path that I've chosen, basically I'll be given different steps to learn based on the path that I've chosen. Okay, I know I'm sounding a bit rhetoric now, but just bear with me because it's really late at night and I'm getting a bit sleepy, but I still wanted to do this vlog. Okay, so let's say I chose a path, and every path it will be filled by a number of steps. Upon the completion of all the steps, you will have completed the path that you have chosen. In every step, there's also a couple of courses that you have to run through. As you can see, some of these courses are locked. Locked courses are only available for people who are on a paid plan. But even on the free plan, you can still try out some basic courses just to have a feel of what the courseware is like. So I really like this interface that they have given. Basically, what this allows you to do is after you've learned about all the content, they give you a simple exercise to do. So let's say I were to do this very simple exercise. Obviously, the starting part is always the simplest, right? But it gets exponentially harder as you go along. But yeah, so every time you finish that, they give you this nice encouragement saying, okay, nice work. They move on to the next page and so on and so forth. So at the start, I would say that the missions in each step are fairly simple to complete. So yeah, basically, that's all I wanted to talk about this part. So now let's just want to show you what the plans are like. So these are the different plans that you can go on. I typically don't really pay for education. I just learn most of my stuff for free on YouTube. But after trying out this course for free, I would say that this is pretty value for money. Let me show you what I mean. So let's say I go into my actual account. Okay, so before that, since I'm on this page anyway, I was doing this solidarity challenge on Strava and I thought it was quite cool. This was the most I've ever ran between this period, April 11th. Since April 11th until today is the 6th of May, and I still got 4 more days to go for this challenge, but I've already done my 10 hours. I really like the challenges that Strava is putting in. Sorry for the short advertisement about Strava, but one more thing I wanted to talk about is this new feature in Strava, which is basically they can flag activities that they've decided that the GPS had a bad day. So what this means is on this run of mine, I actually ran with an average pace of 2:09 seconds per kilometer, which we all know is freaking fast, and definitely I'm not able to run so fast. Even I think Eliud Kipchoge can't run that fast. So this was a 40 run, and it actually gave me my second best estimated 1K effort. I'm not sure why it isn't the best already, but yeah, because they are able to flag out this run, so hopefully they are able to relinquish this medal as well, so I still have a chance of getting a legit 1 km medal. Okay, so back to the Dataquest. Okay, sorry for the short advertisement, but this is the actual account that I'm using. So as you can see, I started using this Dataquest since 1st May. So this month I've spent about 19 hours plus learning. So I'll say about 3 to 4 hours every day. And I've completed 11 missions, the missions that you saw just now. Okay, and also 3 projects. Oh yeah, one more thing to mention is that in every course they usually end off with a project like this. This is a project or a guided project. Okay, so these projects are also for you to. It's also it's like a practical based learning because all this is just theory, right? So the practical part is something that I really enjoy. Maybe I can show you one of the projects that I've done later. I was able to spend 3 to 4 hours every day on this because it is really, really very solid in terms of the learning that they give you. So this part that I was talking about, the guided project, right? Basically, they guide you on a step-by-step process to on an actual problem that you can solve. Where if let's say you were to get into the field of data science. So in this particular project, right, they actually taught me how to use Jupyter Notebook and basically to come up with a whole framework. And this kind of framework, you can actually post it on, you know, like websites like GitHub. I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce it. But basically, you can publish this and put this onto your portfolio in the future next time, which I think will help. I mean, not this kind of default modules, but let's say you already know how to do this framework, you can use this in the future. So in this case, I was actually trying to analyze mobile apps to see what type of apps will actually attract more users in order to maximize revenue, and also some of the assumptions that we made by saying that, okay, we are only doing free to download apps, and so the main source of revenue is only on advertisements within the applications. So basically, you are able to come up with something like this, which is something that I never imagined that I would do just 4 or 5 days ago. Yeah, it's quite interesting. So you get to learn how the step-by-step process on how you actually analyze data and use that analyzed data to actually come up with a meaningful conclusion. Okay, I'm not sure why it's cut off here, but actually I already finished the project. You just have to take my word for it. Okay, yeah, but basically, so yeah, this is the whole data quest thing that I wanted to talk about. Yeah, and also the last thing is that a very nice thing they do for you is that at the end of every course, right, you get an email and then you get a certificate. So this certificate, you can actually add it into your profile as well. So that, you know, if you ever want to move into a career in data science, you can always use this certificate to help you. Like, even as for me, you can see, I'm not really gunning for the data science path. I'm not gunning for the data scientist path because I'm still fairly comfortable where I'm working now. I'm just learning this kind of for fun, but also whether to see whether I can use it to do some meaningful side projects. So I'm taking on the data analyst path because currently this path is the most useful for my current job. Okay, yep, that pretty much wraps up this vlog. Do let me know if you would like to see more of this type of reviews in the future. I will see if I have an opportunity to review, or anything in particular you would like me to answer about Dataquest. I will also try my best to do so. So if you like this, leave a thumbs up. You can share this with your friends if they are interested in learning about data science. And once again, thank you for watching, and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Yeah, thank you, and stay healthy, stay safe.